See, sometimes what happens, the flow of communication would not be proper, or the flow would be obstructed because of certain reasons. So these are known as barriers to communication. The manager is required that he understand these barriers and ensure that when the flow of communication happen, these barriers are removed. Now let's understand what are the different kind of barriers to communication. The first one is your semantic barrier. What is that? This is a kind of linguistic barrier which happens wherein the words would be taken in a different manner. Okay, whatever has been expressed or communication, the meaning is being taken into a totally different manner. For example, badly expressed message. Although the intention of the manager was not to write a rude email, he ended up without realizing that he wrote a very rude email. So rather than saying, normally in the formal communication channel, we use words like please do, even if it is a superior, he would be requesting or he would be telling the subordinate, please do as needful. Now if I tell you, do as needful, doesn't it sound very rude, right? So when the message is badly expressed, it would be a barrier to communication. Symbols with different meanings. Okay, sometimes see, there are certain words which would have different meanings. For example, value. Do I have a value in your life if I tell you like that? Okay, what is the value of gold going on? So you can see how value has a different meaning, right? Similarly, if I tell you I need jam, okay, and then I tell you there is jam outside my house. So now you know jam has two different meanings. So similarly, pool. Even if I say about pool, there are different meanings of pools. Or if we talk about nails. Now when I'm talking about nails, it could be your fingernails, your toenails, or it could be those nails which are used when we are making furniture or when we are doing construction. So when symbols with different meanings are being used, it can lead to barriers to communication. Now faulty translation. See, sometimes the person receiving the message is not a proper translator and he does a faulty translation from one language to another. Suppose the message was supposed to be translated from English to Hindi and he converted the message in a wrong method. So that would be a barrier to communication. Unclarified assumptions. Tomorrow if I tell you that you have to wear the formals and come prepared for the meeting. So what I mean here is that you have to come in formals and be prepared. That means be ready with your presentation. But what you understand is that I need to come prepared. That means I need to be in formals. So here there was an unclarified assumption which was being made. Similarly, suppose if the boss tells the secretary that the guests are going to arrive, the client is going to arrive, take care of them. So the meaning here was she was supposed to ensure that they are settled in the hotel which has been booked for them, okay, and she ensures that they do not face any problem. But what she interprets that they need to be taken to the hotel and that is the only thing which she is required to do. So that is how the barrier to communication arises. Then comes the technical jargon. See, we in general day-to-day business language, we use lot many jargons, okay? So sometimes a subordinate might not be able to understand those jargons. Sometimes we use those short forms ASAP, right? That is as soon as possible. So sometimes the jargons which are being used might not be understandable and that would lead to a barrier to communication. Body language, gesture decoding. Sometimes your body language would act as a barrier to language. Let's say your superior is trying to teach you something, but then your body language is that he feels you're not interested in that. So that is a faulty communication which is going on and that may lead to him stopping the explanation which he was giving. Then comes your psychological barriers. See, these are the barriers which you have in your mind. Okay, sometimes what happens when you're in anger or when you're too happy, right, the way you receive the message would be very different. Or if you're preoccupied with your work, you would receive the communication in a very different manner. So premature evaluation. Now if I go and tell my boss, she or he doesn't have a very good image about me or good opinion about me, Okay, so the moment I go and say I want a holiday, because now before my sentence is completed, he or she makes a assumption that she wants to go on a holiday because she wants to enjoy. Rather, the truth is I want a holiday because my parent or my mother is not keeping well. So that is a premature evaluation of the person's message. Lack of attention. See, many a times it happens that we become dissatisfied, or we become dissatisfied, or maybe our morale comes down, so when we go with a suggestion to the superior, but then the superior is preoccupied with something and he's not putting or he's not giving attention. So that would act as a barrier to communication. See, there could be loss of transmission or poor retention. See, what happens if the communication flows from A to B to C to D like a single chain? Chances are the message loses its original hidden message which was there. What I'm trying to say here, you remember when we were kids, we used to play this game wherein one person was being told a message and he had to pass on, and then we used to see if the 10th person who receives the message receives in the same format or not. And obviously the game used to be really fun because the 10th person never used to say the correct message. So this is what happens even in organizations. The flow of communication gets lost, or there is a loss by transmission, that is the message loses its originality as the transmission happens from one person to another. There could be distrust. So sometimes if a person doesn't trust his superior or the management, then it would act as a barrier to communication. Okay, now the next is organizational barrier. This would be the attitude organization has in terms of employees, in terms of communication. For example, organizational policy. If the organization is very strict, very narrow-minded, and they really don't allow free flow of communication, or they really don't advocate free flow of communication, then the organizational policy would act as a barrier to communication. Rules and regulations. Sometimes the organization wants you to follow the rigid rules and regulation, and hence then what happens, the employees are not encouraged to communicate with each other. There is a lot of rigidity which needs to be followed compulsory, and then it acts as a barrier. Okay, if the structure of the organization is very complex, it is not easy, then the flow of communication also gets obstructed because people get confused whom should be contacted, to whom they should go, who should be contacted for which problem they have. Okay, organizational facilities also create a barrier to communication. Okay, then comes the status. What is status? See, sometimes what happens, certain superiors or managers feel they have a certain status in the organization and they look down on subordinates. So when such a thing is there, then there would be a barrier to communication. Personal barriers. Let's understand what is that. See, sometimes as a personal opinion, I'm very fearful to challenge the authority. Okay, that means I really don't want to challenge my superior. So whatever he says, I say he's correct. Okay, I don't go and give him any suggestions. Okay, because I fear that he would not like it. So when there is a fear of challenging the authority, then it would act as a barrier to communication. See, lack of confidence of superior to a subordinate. I gave you an example. My boss really looked down upon me because he thinks that I'm not utilizing my time properly. Okay, so he doesn't have a very great opinion, or he doesn't have a confidence in me. So in that scenario, as a subordinate, I would not really be interested in communicating with him or giving him any suggestions or telling him something which I feel can be for better use of organization. Unwillingness to communicate. Sometimes if the employee doesn't have the willingness to communicate because of some reasons, then that would act as a barrier to communication. If there are lack of proper incentives. See, if my boss is really not a great person, so he gets he hears a suggestion but then presents it to the management as if they were his suggestion rather than the team suggestion. okay, he doesn't gives me incentive for providing a good suggestion, then because of that I would not be willing to communicate with him, and that would be a barrier to communication.